once again, the it is a feeling of many people that this is a midnight law to be able to get a midnight appointment.
Mr. Chair, I still have the floor if I recall, Mr. Chair. But I will yield to Congressman Goy if he's willing, if he wishes.
You may continue, Congressman.
Just briefly, Manu Roy. Mr. Chair, 5 years is a long time, you know. You'll really be denied depriving. And as to giving security of tenure to the commissioners, there's also the issue of accountability. After 5 years, who are they accountable to? At least congressmen are accountable to the people they have to stand for election every 3 years. But commissioners don't really. It's that accountability is precisely why they are co-terminus with the president, Mr. Chair, in theory, because the president can remove them at any time. So I think that's the counter argument to the. Although I respectfully acknowledge the points made by your good chair, Mr. Chair.
The situation of the Bureau of Immigration and this term case as a commission, these are different. The Bureau of Immigration is basically an administrative body, what is the renders a decision. In the case of the MPC, if I'm not mistaken, all decisions are made after a public hearing. In the Bureau of Immigration, I don't think there's any need for a public hearing. And because of that, we should liken the MPC to other quasi-judicial bodies. And like SEC, for example, the SEC would be a very good model. And I think for the stability of the MPC, to make it a truly independent body, considering the power that it wields over an industry that is becoming a very dominant industry. Maybe 20 years ago, it wasn't so. But right now, the future of the country will depend on how we manage our telecommunications sector, including the ITC sector. As we all know, the IT entities all over the world, India, Germany, the United States, and even the Philippines, have become super big entities. BPO is getting bigger and bigger, IT is getting bigger and bigger, and here, the NTC will become very important. And in the opinion of this representation, this is where the stabilizing factor of a big term is going to be very important. If we were discussing this maybe 2 years ago, probably it would not be a problem. But right now, there are two factors that come into the discussion, primarily presidential consideration. Some sectors would not want the incumbent president to be the one to appoint the members of the commission who would sit for the next 3 years or 5 years, depending on the term you would decide on. On the other hand, I think whoever is going to be the president, some people also would like to tie the hand of the next president to make sure that the incumbency of an NPC commissioner would not depend on the will and caprice of the appointing party. So there must be stability here, and I go for a fixed term, 3 years or 5 years. What we have to deal with now is find a solution to the issue of who's going to appoint. So I think we can have a very creative solution here. If some people are worried that the incumbent president should shy away from appointing, I think we can find a solution there without compromising the stability of the NPC itself in the future. To my mind, a fixed term is very necessary to enable the NPC to become really a sober, independent body to supervise a very vital, dominant sector, which the telecommunications sector has become, and will probably even become bigger in the coming years. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman. I fully subscribe to the advice of Congressman Nangara and Congressman Gomez. There needs to be stability in the sector, and the stability can come from a fixed term for the commission in the NRC. However, because of the probably we can come up with the compromise to the compromise. For those who are already in the commission, they can be given all over probably current administration get them to buy or get them apply for the things that the commission has committed. This may be a large compromise for the leaders and for this
nation. And I just want to emphasize that the fixed term that is being fixed here for the associate commissioners is only 3 years. It's only the chairman who has been given a 5-year fixed term. If we just adopt in principle that the president can appoint, we are not changing this law. There is no relevance anymore of the formal reorganization and reform provisions of this law, because the incumbent just has a coterminous status. Therefore, we are not changing his status and can be fired at any time. And therefore, the fixed term concept will not apply. The second point that I emphasize is that the framers of the Constitution itself consider, at worst, a so-called midnight appointment, if done within 2 months before the election. Now, the eventual status of the speech will actually depend upon what we will do in the House and what we will do in the Senate. We have barely a few days to go. Therefore, I would urge, in the same manner as we did for the VIP and the other agencies, we pass this bill as that the committee considers this as it stands now, and let us also await the decision of the Senate now. But I agree wholeheartedly with the statement of Congressman Goddard that it's very important to make a distinction between MTC and even VIP, or even with PAMCOR. I think MTC should be equated, say, with an institution like this, which is the commission, or the insurance commission, and the NRC. They be quasi-judicial bodies. Providing for a fixed term is actually the shortest term that can be issued. Because in the case of the judiciary and other quasi-judicial bodies, it's not necessary.